Hey everyone, this is Nick here again with another quick tip on how to create some really cool text effects in PowerPoint. And I'm going to show you today four different ways that you can create this beautiful gradient-filled text. It's a great way to sort of engage your reader. If you are creating a presentation or any other type of document in PowerPoint, this could be one of those ways to really grab your audience's attention and make them think, ooh, you are a cool designer and you did this. You must have done this in some really expensive design software, but no, you just did it in PowerPoint, what you already use and access every single day. So let's go over to the first way to do this. And this is probably the way that most people would think to do this, and that's just by editing the actual text box or the fill of the text that you have in your text box on your slide. So let's go ahead and get out of this onto my demonstration slide. You can see right here, we just have a normal text box. You're gonna wanna make your text any size that you want. I want a nice, big, thick text box right here, gradient filled text, and I'm gonna, right here, you can see that it's just filled in black. But what you wanna do here is highlight your text box and then go up to, make sure you're on the Home tab, and then go up to the Shape Format tab right here on the ribbon. And you're not gonna go to this section right here, which is the Shape Fill. That would fill your entire text box. Instead, you wanna go over here to the Text Fill options, and I'm gonna go ahead and select that option, and you can see that you could fill the text here from with any of the colors in my palette there. You can also see that once you do this, the format shape dialog box menu on the right pops up here, and right now we're selected on shape options. We could actually click over here and go to text options, and now I'm going to be editing the text that I see right here. The color is yellow. So instead of a solid color or no fill or a solid fill, let's go over here to gradient fill. Once I click on that, it's going to give me these additional settings, and you can already see that my text has started to change. So you can go here, look at the presets that they have for the different gradients. You can say, select the type of gradient that you want. You could do linear, radial, rectangular. I'm going to stick on linear for now. The direction, you can click on these, and this would take you from, you know, top to bottom or right to left or left to right in terms of the lightest color that you have and the darkest color that you have. I'm going to stick to the one that we have right here, which is this option here. It's called linear right. And so my white stop is all the way on the left and my yellow is all the way on the right. You can see here the gradient stops are right here. I have two of them, and these are these little slider bars. So if I slide them, you can play with the gradient. You can make it thicker, you can make it more solid that way. You could also play with the white and make the white go over, and that pretty much erases everything. So you can also add stops here, and that's what I wanna do, because I wanna be able to make my gradient text look like this first slide here with, I think there are five different colors in this text right here. So I'm gonna go back here, I'm gonna click on my text box, go to gradient here. Oops, we're gonna get out of this. We gotta make sure that we're under the text options right here. And so I'm under gradient here. I'm gonna go ahead and add three different gradient stops. So I'm just gonna click on this plus sign right here, add gradient stop, 1, 2, and 3, and then I can actually just drag them to evenly space them. You can actually work with the positioning percentage right here if you wanted it to be exact, and maybe I do. So this one I'm gonna put to 25%, this one I'll put to 50%. So that just gives you the position along the line, the gradient stop line. This one I'll put to 75%, and now I'm gonna update the colors for each. So this white one, I'm gonna change to blue, and then I'm just gonna go along the top color chip of my palette here, this nice aqua or teal color, and then this nice aqua blue, and then maybe this one's gonna be the red, and then this one, I'm probably gonna keep yellow. I could do the orange too, but I kinda like the yellow, so I'm gonna keep the yellow there. And this is my way number one to make beautiful gradient filled text. Now you can actually edit this text. The gradient will stay. So I could say something else. I could edit. I could just say this is a new text box here. Oops. Let's get that. And so you can see I can type new text in here and that gradient will continue to exist. I can also update the font size. I can make it smaller. I can make it larger. In that way, I like to keep my text 150 for this one. So you can do it like that. So that's another way to update your text. So stay tuned on the flip side for way number two. We're gonna use an insert a shape, and then we're gonna use our merge shapes tools to figure out how to make kind of a cookie cutter effect or a mask with some of our text here. So stay tuned for that on the flip side. All right, now this is way number two to create that beautiful gradient filled text. And we're gonna do that by using the merge shapes menu, and we're specifically gonna use the subtract feature on that menu to create kind of a cookie cutter effect with our text box and another shape that we insert over the slide. So let's head over to my demonstration slide. And here we just have our normal text box, this black solid filled text box, gradient filled text right on the slide. I positioned it perfectly and I made it the right size. It's 150 point font. I really like that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to first insert a shape. So I'm going to insert a rectangle, and I'm just going to make this the entire, I'm going to actually drag this so that it fills the entire height and width of the slide. And I want to make sure that my slide can be seen. So I might decrease this just a little bit. Okay, my whole slide is there. And I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to get rid of my lines of the on the shape. So I'm going to say no line on the rectangle. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to send this rectangle back, because everything in PowerPoint works in layers. So anything that you insert on the slide is going to automatically go onto the top layer on top of everything else on the slide. So I'm going to go ahead and send that backwards so I can see it. And then what you want to do now is you want to make sure we're going to select both of these things, the shape and the text box. But you have to do it the shape first. So we're going to go ahead and click on the box first, the rectangle first. Then I'm going to hold down shift and I'm going to select my text box. And now I'm going to go up here to the shape format tab that's already selected. Over here under the insert shapes menu of options here, we have this merge shapes drop-down menu, and I'm going to go ahead and click that, and we're going to go ahead and go to fragment. We're going to go ahead and click on subtract. Number three, we're going to do fragment, but right now we're going to do subtract. And so I'm going to go ahead and click subtract. And now you can see that it's basically cookie cuttered that text out of this shape. Now I can actually, adjust the size of the shape if I wanted to do it like this. I'm going to go ahead and click undo, and that's just going to put it back. But you see that it's not gradient yet. So how do I make it gradient? Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to work with the background of the slide. I'm going to fill the background of the slide with a different color. And since I already previously set up my gradient that I wanted, that five color gradient from my palette, as soon as I click on the gradient option, that gradient will probably still appear. I won't have to reset my gradient. So let's go over here. Right now it's set to solid fill and it's just white. And that's going to be the background of the slide. If I go ahead and click on gradient fill, my gradient that I created before pops right up, and I could go ahead and I can move this right over the slide. And now if I play the slide, it looks like some beautiful gradient filled text with a blue background. Now I could also just change I could highlight this shape, the cookie cutter, and I could change the fill color of the shape. Maybe we want to make it white. So that's perfect. Maybe I want to make it red. I could do that. Or any of these other colors. So that's one cool way that you can create a gradient filled text with this cookie cutter or design mask effect and manipulating or editing the background color of your slide. So that's another kind of cool trick to do. So stay tuned to trick number three. We're going to do the same thing with merge shapes, but instead of subtract, we're going to use the fragment option on that menu, and you'll see what that does in just a second. All right, we are on number three, way number three to create beautiful gradient filled text. And we are going to use the merge shapes menu again, and we're going to use the fragment option this time instead of the subtract. So let's go over to my demonstration slide. We have the beautiful gradient filled text again, just a normal text box with some text in it and the black text. I'm going to go ahead and insert my blue, the rectangle. I'm going to do that over the entire way of the slide. We're going to send it to back just like we did last time. And now this time we're going to use that merge shapes menu, but we're going to use the fragment option, and we'll see what that does. So go ahead and click the rectangle shape first, hold down shift, and your text box shape menu is selected, shape format menu is selected from the tab, from the ribbon, and then go to merge shapes, and then we're going to go to fragment. And you can see when I do that and click that, it actually makes every single shape, every single cookie cutter, its own shape. So all of those different lines are telling you that every single thing on here, every place where the text has intersected with that blue box, is now its own shape. So let's go ahead and unselect that. So everything is unselected. If I click on this, it's just going to select sort of the background. I could go ahead and delete it, click backspace. And now you can see every single letter is its own shape. Even the insides, the holes of the R, the A's, those are their own shapes too. So we actually have to go through and delete those. So just click them, highlight them individually, and delete them. That looks great. Now in this way, every single letter is its own shape. And so in this way, I could actually make a staggered gradient, or I could do like every other letter be that gradient fill text, which would be pretty cool. So let's go ahead, click on this one shape. My format shape menu pops up. I'll click on gradient, and there's a nice gradient there. Gradient there. That's really cool. Now that's really cool. Now I'm going to show you another quick keyboard shortcut. If I were to do Shift Control and C, you have to do not Control C, that would copy it. But if I do Shift Control C, that's going to copy the formatting. So now if I go to this F, I click on this F, and now instead of Control V for paste, I do Shift Control V. That is going to update the formatting, and it should update it with that gradient color. So let's try and see if that happens. Shift Control V. Yep, it did that. And that stays on my clipboard. So I could just click this L, Shift Control V, E, Shift Control V. We'll do this, Shift Control V. Awesome. So that copies, that's a quick keyboard shortcut to copy formatting of any of the objects. Now, if I wanted this all to be one object, all I have to do is highlight everything. So drag your mouse and select everything here. Oops, I'm going to do this here, make sure to fill everything. That highlights all the letters. Now I'm going to group them. So you could go ahead and right click and then click on group. Now that groups everything like one object, and now it treats it as one single shape. So if I go over here to the format shape menu and go to gradient, everything will change. And now the whole text box will be a single gradient, just like before. You can see there are outlines along the around each of the letters. If I didn't want those, all I have to do is go down to the line formatting option and click on no line. And now none of the lines exist. So that's way number three to use the merge shapes and fragment option from that menu. Now way number four is going to be our final way, and it's going to involve downloading that wonderful free PowerPoint productivity add-in called BrightSlide by the company called Bright Carbon. So go ahead and download that, and I'll see you in the next video. All right, everyone, this is tip number four. This is way number four on how to make beautiful gradient-filled text on your slide in PowerPoint, and it's going to involve downloading a free PowerPoint add-in called BrightSlide. They have so many different cool click-of-a-button features that will help you be more productive in your PowerPoint design and slideshow building products. And even if you have, like, you don't have administrator rights, email your IT person and just tell them that you need this add-in. It's free, and it's really easy to download. So make sure that they enable that feature for you and get BrightSlide. Let's go over here to the demonstration slide and we'll get started. So again, we just have our plain black text box, gradient filled text. And now what we want to do is when you download the add-in BrightSlide, you'll have a new tab up here on the ribbon called BrightSlide. So I'm going to go ahead and click that. Under the legacy tools, if you don't have legacy tools enabled, that might, you might just need to enable that. When you do it, just Google how to enable legacy tools on BrightSlide, and it'll show you the button to click. So go ahead and click this, and under this option under here, text, it says text to outline. Now when I click this, any text box that I have highlighted here will now essentially become a shape, and it'll give me a few different options on a dialog box that will pop up, and we'll see what I mean by that when I click this. So go ahead and click text to outline. And now it says, what shall we do with your source shapes? Do you want us to keep your text box and move it off to the side and keep and put your shape in the slide? Or do you want us to keep the text box and hide it? Or do you want us to just replace your text with a shape? In this case, I'm going to say keep and move off slide so that you can see what that looks like. That would be a great tip to use if you think that maybe you want to update your text later on, because once you create the shapes, you can't update the text with it. You have to, they're essentially just normal shapes, and that's all you have. So let's just keep the text and move it off to the side, and you'll see what happens when I click OK. It's going to give me that, and you can see this now has become a shape. This is a single shape on the slide, and right up here, if we make this slide smaller, you can see that the text box is now off to the side, and I can edit this text box like I normally would. I can just go ahead and you can edit the text like that, but we can't do that with the shape below. So let's go back down here, we'll zoom back in, and now I can treat this like a single shape. When I click it, the shape menu pops up, the shape format shape menu pops up, and instead of solid fill, I'll go ahead and click on gradient fill, and there we go. If I wanted to update the line, the outline of the shape, all I have to do is go to the line menu down here, And let's put that down. We'll do a solid line here. We could also update the thickness or the color. So right now it's a pretty thin blue, but I could update the weight of that line. Maybe let's go all the way up to 5 points, a nice thick outline on that text. So that's another way. That's the last way that I have to create beautiful gradient-filled text on your slide. I hope that you enjoyed these 4 ways, and I hope that they inspired some interesting ideas in your own PowerPoint slide building. I hope that you give this video a like, a thumbs up, and also I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel. Each time I post a new video on data design, PowerPoint, Excel, things like that, you'll get a notification of when that pops up and you'll be able to watch. I hope you comment and share it with others too. So thanks again for watching, and I will see you next time.